Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. Thank you for your well wishes for my mom and for Bruce. My mom is still here. That's a win. I will take that. Bruce is doing okay. He's healing. Both here, and really that's all I can ask. I spent the past day or two trying to get caught up in my cousin. When we got the news about my mom not doing that great, I stopped journaling in here, which is real life. So this is my A5 cousin. This is my A5 hun, cousin size, in the leather logbook. So let's start with my cousin. And this is sort of like my brain dump journaling planner. So this is what I did for this week. I put washi on the top and the bottom. I'm not too sure if I like it. I did it last year too, and I'm just not sure if this is what I would like to do, because this is what I did last week, where I just put washi on the bottom. So if you like washi on the bottom and the top, give this video a like. I like it because it fills up the page, but at the same time, I sort of like the way this looks too. So this is the weekly layout. I will fill out the task that I need to get done that day. And then the packages are over here. So this is sort of like a nice muted look. This is last week. Then the week before, again, top and bottom. And then the monthly layout still looks the same. I don't think I've updated it at all. Thankfully, no earthquakes felt, so I didn't have to put another one down, which is great. Now let's go to the daily page. I think this is sort of where I've left off from my last video. So this is Bruce and my husband when we were at the vet on the 8th. I finally drew in the dragon. Here's Bruce. This is a magazine cutout that I taped in, and it says cultivating resilience. And I plan to talk a little bit about my mom and Bruce and what I've been feeling the past couple of weeks/months. That's Kit Kat asleep on the couch. Another magazine cutout. I washed Bruce's flannel blanket. It was still warm when I laid it down, so the cat decided he wanted to try it before Bruce took it over and decided to sleep on a warm blanket. Here are two poems that I found on Facebook in I can't remember if it was like a book page, Facebook page, but one is a poem by Beatrice Potter. And the second one is by Tony C. Franklin, and it's called Where the Path Begins. The stickers are from Happy Planner. And this one, I really like the poem. It says, "The end of the road is where the path begins. You can choose to go alone or travel with friends. Tombstones hold two dates, when life begins and when it ends. But the dash in between is what's important to family and friends. Live, love, and dance before you lose the chance." And I just felt this poem was really appropriate. Sort of hit home. And sometimes I think poems kind of pop up for me. Quotes, singing, when I need to hear it the most. So that's why it's on this page. And again, it's by Tony C. Franklin. Under here is a picture of my niece and her fiance. They were in downtown Disney. Here's Kit Kat on my lap. This is a photo. So this is my husband's old truck that he purchased last year. I planted my mom likes freesia bulbs. She likes freesia. They're very fragrant, and I bought some bulbs and I went ahead and planted her little, it's like a citrusy bush. When the flowers open, they smell like citrus, like lemon. And then this is a palmera. And then I planted the freesia bulbs in there. And then over here, which you can't really see, is my avocado seedling. There's Bruce sleeping on my husband. So last Wednesday, we visited my mom. So some family selfies with my mom. This is my mom in better days at her house, at home, with the cake. Here's her cymbidium. This is going to be the last photo of her cymbidium, only because it's finally in full bloom and it's really pretty. And the buds now, the flowers are starting to die out now, but I wanted to take a picture and then put it on this page. Today's Friday. And then here's Bruce sleeping on his blanket. And then here he was gnawing on his bone. Over here, this is my A5 Hun. This I have beside me every single day. This is the Traveler's Notebook, standard size. I use this as my meals. Supposed to be exercise step tracker. So here I keep track of my weight. So here is January. So the weight is colored and then the steps are not. The little asterisks are the times that I charge my tracker that I wear on my wrist. And this, I keep saying this in every video, but this has really been great keeping it in the log that I'm able to fill it out. So even though I may not fill it the day of, so today's Friday, so as you can see, I didn't fill out Thursday, but generally when I'm drinking coffee in the morning, I will fill this out as well as the weights and steps. But this has been working really great. I meant to do a little bit more of my arm weights and my squats with weights, but I haven't, so I'm gonna try and do that today. Here I keep track of my sleep. And in here I have stickers. This I purchased from Traveler's Notebook also. I am using this as my writer's notebook. I am hoping to self-publish next year. And so I've been working on my stories. These stickers are from Happy Planner. This is the monthly layout. This is how I've been using it. I'm only putting down really important dates. So for instance, you know, Bruce's flea meds, his appointments, our water delivery. The ones with the little cats are writing classes that I am retaking. And then blue, that was my, our gardener went on vacation. And then we have street cleaning. This is for next month. But you can see how really simple I'm trying to keep this. And then let's go to the weekly layout. This is really, really functional compared to what I did in my cousin. So since I have this beside me, this I always fill out every day. Whereas with this one, it's more of a catch up. Generally, like Wednesday-ish, maybe Sunday, I will pull this out, have this open, or transfer this information into my cousin. And then I'm discovering I don't like washi on the bottom of this Hun. So I had a little bit of strip left. I just pulled it out because I discovered I don't really like it in here. I sort of like this really plain, simple, no washi on the bottom. Really functional. And then these are the highlighter markers that I picked up. So here's a bag that I picked up from Daiso. These are pins from Disney or Knott's Berry Farm. This one is for my Mustang. I have a 68 Mustang, but I bought this a long time ago when I bought my car. But these are markers that I purchased. Let's see, these guys. I purchased from Daiso. So these are the ones that I use, but I have a bunch of them in here. I have a bunch of things. And this bag is also beside me when I'm writing. But I like how this has come. Other than the washi tape, I like the layout. I like what I've been doing in here. And then I like the bits of color. And in case you're wondering, other than the tippins, with the stickers, with the random stickers and the washi tape that I've been putting down, you can see it's really not that thick at all. It has not chunked up. My intention with this one is to obviously not chunk it up. I want to keep it like this so that when I'm finished with this HON, I can put it in my bookshelf and start the next one for 2025. So this is what this week looks like. And then mail is over here. And then the thing I want to show you on the daily page. So today is the 23rd, and I don't have too much here. I don't think that's gonna spoil my story. This is the Daiso charm that I picked up. And so the colors here is where these highlighters that I showed you a couple seconds ago would come in. I like to color it in. So this is what a blank one would look like. Up here, I did keep track of my task blocks, and I think I had home, work, and something else, writing. And then I did little squares, and then I would color it in if I spent at least half an hour doing it. But I didn't do it up here. I have not been keeping track of that. I don't know if I'm gonna get back into that, and the sun is coming back out. But that's what I want to show you in here. This has been working really well. I love the HON. It's the hardcover. So in case you didn't know, the difference between the HON and the Cousin is that this is literally a hardcover cover. You don't really need like another planner to slide it into. I prefer it in here using the traveler's notebook, where I can keep track of my stuff. And so when I move around from, say, the kitchen table to the TV tray, where my laptop is at, where I work, I can carry this with me and have it beside me while I am writing. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos of my Cousin and my A5 HON. I hope you guys have a great weekend. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!